I just don't want to break the flow because there's still such a healing anointing here. And for any of you who might have missed the programs that we've been doing about the Father and the impartation of the love of the Father, if you tuned in this week, or maybe you're watching on the web or online, and you know deep down that you really need healing from not having a great earthly father, or maybe you were abandoned, maybe you never had an earthly father, maybe your father, earthly father, abused you, maybe sexually, maybe emotionally, maybe with anger. There is for all these wounds that come up in your life that affect your decisions, that affect your relationships in your family, maybe even with your wife or your husband or with your children, things that the devil has been trying to trip you up with. For some of you, maybe for 40 years, for some of you 50, maybe for some just a few years. There is a healing anointing right now that if you just lift your hands right now, the healing power of the Lord is here. The healing power of the Lord Jesus is here. The healing power of the Father is here. The healing power, the tender mercies and the compassion of the Father, of the Heavenly Father, is here for you to heal your heart, to heal your emotions, to heal you today. And Father, I just thank you. Holy Spirit, we just thank you for your healing anointing. Thank you for your healing anointing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are reading. I see the Holy Spirit, he's actually reading like radar. Like I see like radar going, he's reading many of your hearts, and he's getting to the wounds, and he's just pouring fresh oil, and he's pouring the love of the Father. He's pouring the love and the tender mercies and the compassion of the Father on those dry places, I see thorns. I see many thorns in many hearts. I see some of the thorns have been pushed so well in that, you know what, it doesn't even look like that's a thorn there, but you know, it looks like, but on the heart, it looks like there's a black, just a little bruise there, because for some of you, these things have been so pushed down. And you know what, and I see now, I see it's almost like, I don't know if it's Jesus' hand or the Father's hand, but I see a hand just taking out and easing out the thorns, even those ones. God doesn't want any thorn to stay there. He doesn't want those bruises there. So Father, I ask, Father, that as there are those ones, Father, that you know need your touch today. Father, that as these ones are opening their hearts to you, oh, Lord Jesus, beloved Father, I ask that you go in there and with your compassionate hand, that you just take out these thorns. Take out these thorns of injustice. Oh, take out these thorns of misrepresentation. These thorns of judgment. Some of you were judged. Some of you were so misunderstood by your father that it's led to you having a fear of authority, of male authority. And this has just gone into many areas of your life, not just in church life, but I feel even for you in business. You need healing. You need healing. You need healing. You need healing. You need healing, says the Lord. You need healing. I sense that there's some pastors' wives there. You need healing. You need healing. Oh, Father. Oh, Father. And now the Lord, it's come to a stage where some of you need to forgive. Some of you really have. You've tried so hard to forgive, but there's an anointing here now. There is the anointing of the Father is here. So if you know you need to just confess that right now in the presence of the Father, when his healing power is here to heal you, then just confess and say, Father, 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 forgive my father for despitefully using me. Forgive my father for misunderstanding and misinterpreting, Father, my motivations, my motives. Oh, Father, forgive my father, Father, for emotionally abusing me. Forgive him for his anger. Oh, Father, I feel for many of you, you need to forgive your fathers for abandoning you. Say, Father, forgive my father for abandoning me. Oh, Father, and as you forgive, it's going to release you. I see you, multitudes, the thorns, that God doesn't even have to take them out by his hand now because they go, phew, I see them popping out through that forgiveness. Oh, Father, I ask, Father, that as your healing compassions touch your sons and daughters' heart, Father, that, Father, you came that they may have joy and life abundantly, that they may start to feel some of the joy. You know, I felt that the Father said there are some of you who have been in depression that you have not experienced real joy for a long, long time, all to do with the wounds of your father, all to do with the wounds of not knowing your Heavenly Father's, your earthly Father's love, but not knowing your Heavenly Father's love. And now, Father, I ask, Father, I ask for all those who have not known, Father, who have not known your tangible presence. Father, I ask, Father, that they would know from this moment on your tangible presence, Father. Father, I ask that their relationship with you, Father, would know no bounds. Father, I ask that you would wake them in the morning and wake them in the evening, that they would run to you, that they would not just know you as Father, but they would know you as their Daddy. Oh, you know, if you haven't known the Father, if the Father has been far off to you, I ask that you say this prayer after me. Father, I come before you as your child in the name of your beloved Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, I haven't known you in intimacy. I ask that I would know your all-consuming love and mercies for me. Father, I ask that I would know you as my Daddy. As my Daddy, that you would take me up as your Daddy on your knee and hold me to your breast and love me as even if you would love a babe in arms. Father, I thank you that you hear these ones who pray this prayer. Father, I thank you that even now you would lift them up and just hold them to your breast, Father, and love them. And I see the Father singing lullabies over you, the lullabies your Father never sang over you when you were little, when you were a baby. The lullabies your Father never sang over you, the Father is singing over you today. And now, and this is what I felt on the last program. I felt that the Lord said, that the Father said, that there were many of you whose destinies in Him and whose visions in Him and whose callings in Him had literally been stunted, been aborted, because of this tremendous healing that had not taken place, that needed to be taken place. And so right now, in the closing moments of this program, I'm just going to pray a release upon destinies, these destinies. Father, you know who these ones are, these men and women, Father. Father, whose destinies have been stunted, Father, who've only grown so much when you created them. I see some trees that are only that high, and God the Father created you to be these magnificent oaks and provide cover and sustenance and life for so many, many people. Some you are meant to provide life for thousands of people, and some you have worldwide ministry ahead, but you have been so bound by these past things because of your earthly Father, because of wounds, that your ministry has not been able to start. Your calling, it's not only in ministry, it's also in the marketplace. That's still ministry. We must not be religious about these things in this end time hour. That's ministry too. Some of you are called by God to the marketplace, but your ministry has been aborted and it has not been flowing as it should. So Father, I thank you, Father, that as your sons and daughters have forgiven their fathers, Father, that as your sons and daughters have started to feel your embrace, Father, and your healing touch, Father, I thank you, Father, that you release upon them from heaven, Father, from your throne in heaven, Father, your destiny that you created from their conception, oh, Father. And right now, in the name and in the authority of the Father, in the name of his beloved Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, I activate that destiny upon your life right now, that which the Father conceived you for, that which he handpicked you for, before the beginning of time, from before the foundations of the earth, he knew you. For such a purpose you were born. I activate right now that purpose and that calling for your destiny right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Father, I thank you for your angelic host, Father, assigned to these ones to bring about their vision, to bring about their calling, to bring about their ministry, to bring about their ministry in the secular world, to bring about their ministry in the marketplace, Father. Father, I just thank you for divine supernatural activation, divine supernatural activation, divine supernatural activation, a speeding up, a suddenly in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, freedom from abandonment, freedom from deferred hope, Freedom from deferred hope, says the Lord. Freedom from deferred hope. And fulfillment of every promise from the Father to you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. We love you, Father. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Father, for each one watching, Father, today. Father, to feel your love and know your presence, Father, and your consuming passion for them, Father. Amen.